In this video, we will demonstrate and we will talk about pulsus paradoxus. So this is a very specific character of pulse which is known as pulsus paradoxus. What is pulsus paradoxus? Pulsus paradoxus is defined as fall of systolic blood pressure more than 10 millimeter of mercury during inspiration. When we say that fall of systolic blood pressure more than 10 millimeter of mercury means normally, maybe physiologically, when we inspire, systolic blood pressure falls. But this fall should not be more than 10 millimeters of mercury. When it is more than 10 millimeter mercury, it is known as pulsus paradoxus. What are the conditions where you get pulsus paradoxus? The most common condition is cardiac tamponade. Second is acute severe asthma or acute exacerbation of chronic obstructive pulmonary diseases. Tension pneumothorax, acute pulmonary embolism. These are situations where we get pulsus paradoxus. Why? So basically it is an exaggeration of the normal physiology. Physiologically speaking, the systolic blood pressure falls around less than 10 millimeter of mercury during inspiration, because when we inspire, venous return is more to the right side of the heart. When the venous return is more in the right side of the heart, less blood is present during inspiration in the left ventricle. So the cardiac output is little bit less, systolic blood pressure little bit less during inspiration. But this should not be more, the fall should not be more than 10 millimeters of mercury. So how to suspect that the patient is having pulsus paradoxus and how to quantify? And what is the meaning of this paradox? Why there is a paradox? The paradox is this, that even if the heart sounds are heard during inspiration, there is no pulse. This is the paradox. Heart sounds are audible, but the volume of pulse or the pulse is absent or the volume is decreasing severely. So this is the paradox. Now we'll see how to suspect and how to quantify. So Dr. Siddharth,
yes, sir.
Can you just tell us how to suspect that this patient or some patient is having pulsus paradoxus?
So, due to the causes of pulsus paradox, patient complains dyspnea. And normally we check.
Yes, the patient will already having tachypneic or dyspneic. Obviously, we have enlisted the condition.
Yes.
But when we come to the bedside of the patient and we start seeing the pulse,
yes,
and how you will suspect that, yes, probably I am dealing with a different abnormal character, that is pulsus paradoxus.
Yes,
normally, can you demonstrate it?
Yes, sir. Normally we check for the radial pulse and we found out that there is a low volume pulse or absent pulse during inspiration and a normal volume pulse during expiration.
Okay, this so the background is very good. The background, as he rightly pointed out, when we are examining the pulse and the patient is tachypneic, say for example, dyspneic, whatever the situation is, I am seeing that when the patient is inspiring, the volume of the pulse is decreasing. Or maybe I am not able to palpate the pulse when the patient is inspiring. When he is expiring, the pulse is coming. As rightly said by Dr. Siddharth, this is the scenario where we will suspect pulsus paradoxus. Now, Dr. Saurabh, can you demonstrate how to quantify pulsus paradoxus? Please.
First of all, we make a patient in a semi-recumbent position. Then, by using a BP apparatus, we increase the BP apparatus. And by palpatometer, we look for systolic blood pressure. Now, I am inflating a cuff. At 140 mmHg, I already have ablated the radial artery. It indicates that is systolic blood pressure. Now, by auscultatory method, I will look for systolic blood pressure. Now, I already know that patient has systolic blood pressure at 140 by palpatory method. Now, I am increasing mercury by more than 20. Now, I am slowly release the cuff. At 140 of mmHg, I hear a cuff peripheral sound. Now, slowly release. And I hear a peripheral sound only on expiration. At 120 mmHg, I hear coronal sound in both expiration and inspiration. This is a paradox. That means at 140 mmHg, I hear a coronal only in expiration, while in 120 mmHg, I hear in both cycle of respiration, that inspiration and expiration. So here paradox is more than 20 mmHg, that is pathological.
So as rightly demonstrated by Dr. Saurabh, what he did, he first detected the systolic blood pressure by palpatory method. By auscultatory method, he knew that the systolic blood pressure is around 140 mm of mercury. He took the mercury manometer above 20 mm of mercury. Then he started to deflect. At say 140 mm of mercury, he could hear the Korotkov sounds. Then he was hearing the Korotkov sounds only during expiration. During inspiration, he was not hearing it. Then he gradually deflected the mercury manometer. And till 120 mm of mercury, he could hear the Korotkov sounds only during expiration. He could not hear the Korotkov sound during inspiration. But at 120 mm of mercury, he could hear the Korotkov sounds in both phases of respiration, that is in inspiration and expiration. So there is doubling of Korotkov sounds at 120. So from 140 to 120 is the paradox. So the answer will be here, after demonstrating the pulses paradoxes is of 20 mm of mercury in this case. Thank you.